Since the 2021 general elections ended, police say they have registered a number of cases in which some politicians are accused of using forged academic documents. Other complainants have gone to court. Police are investigating these claims and have warned that if they are true, the offenders face prosecution.
The process of prosecution is not instant, and therefore our investigation may not make, for example, a successful candidate to leave his seat, either the member of parliament or a local government leader.
CID spokesperson Charles Twine says that police does not verify the documents that politicians use to vie for these positions.
Our emphasis is only on forgery and uttering false documents. Issues of quality can be challenged in courts of law in a civil case kind of arrangement.
So as UNEP, we cannot compel political aspirants to come and verify. However, when they do verify, we do provide the information and we always give them special treatment to ensure they can be able to access their documents in time.
Meanwhile, on the other side of town, a group including Muhammad Segirinya, the MP elect for Kawempe North, carried placards demanding the release of political prisoners who are members of the National Unit Platform Party. Police arrested him and detained him in a booth at the old taxi park before he was transferred to the Central Police Station in Kampala.
To record his statement on allegations of inciting violence. We have only zeroed on him alone. There are, of course, others.
Also, police spokesperson Fred Enanga said they are investigating incidents of what they suspect are organized crimes involving unsuccessful attempts to touch two fuel stations during the weekend. One person has been arrested in Buyukwe district in possession of an explosive device.
We are not going into concluding whether it is something of domestic terror, but maybe the investigations will lead us as we go on.
Twine said they have taken DNA samples from three women who were killed and their bodies burnt in Nakulabye, a suburb of Kampala.
At least it was conclusively established that what was burnt was a dead body. The cause of death was not fire. Somebody would be killed, then they bring the dead body and set it ablaze.
Juma Kiria, NTV.